this. This supposedly takes us like 3 hours to do this. I won't put you guys through 3 hours of this. Maybe just start it out and try chatting and Legoing a little bit with you guys, and then maybe do some more Hearthstone. We'll see, because I've been wanting to do, I got this for Christmas, and I've been wanting to work on it. I thought, well, maybe I'll work on it with my awesome homies. So yeah, that'd be pretty cool. But let's get started on the meatloaf, because everything's preheating. I'm going to link the menu or the recipe in chat. As well as look at the recipe. I thought you would like that one deadly kitten. I know you love Legos. I figured you'd come and then you'd coach me through it. Did you see it? I'll probably work on it. I don't know if I'll do the whole thing. Maybe we'll do part today, part tomorrow, or part today, part next week. We'll see how fast it goes. Alright, so let's see. We need to create some coconut oil. So we're going to make one of my favorite meatloaf recipes. Hey, Ash, thank you for the host here. I came here just to scope it out. Okay, well, you know, now that you know you've scoped it out, you can go now. I get it. It's fine. let's see. Hope you're having a better day today, Deadly Kitten. All right, so what we're doing is we're making one of my favorite meatloaf recipes. Oh, okay. I thought you said you were just scoping it out and then you were leaving is what I was... is what I thought I heard you say there. Maybe when you saw it was an Iowa Lego puzzle, you were not sold on it. So we're going to use coconut oil here. We're going to saute up these just to cook them and soften them up. We're going to put that in our raw meat for our meatloaf. And then we're going to bake the meatloaf. I'm going to make some brown rice as a side with it. And then we're going to eat it. And we're going to store it. And we're going to do a puzzle. So that should be good. All right, we'll do... tablespoon here. I usually get the garlic. Well, I'll show you the garlic that I usually get. Coconut oil, so good. So I commonly use this like minced garlic. You can find it usually at the grocery stores. Yeah, you can't go wrong with garlic. I mean, it's in my Italian blood that I have to have garlic on everything. Apparently, I haven't opened this up yet. Oh, might need assistance on this one. This one's... she's a tight one there. Boom. Woo! That was a struggle. Whoa! Alright. Let's try. Alright, fireworks, guys! Woo! Alright, well, that was unexpected. Cool off. Come on, chill out there. Chillax a little bit. Well, that's going to be a mess there. That was unexpected. I tried a different garlic this time, and it doesn't... never usually have that much issue with it. So we're just going to put that over there to cool off a little bit, think about what it's done. I know, right? I had to use all the muscles today. I did a really tough workout this morning. And my grip's really good, too, so it was pretty surprising how hard that was to get open, but... bought one of these a long time ago, just like a rubber grip that really helps out a lot. Hey, Bruno Chap, how you doing, mate? I don't know why I gave you the Australian accent there. All right, well, we made a mess, but we're still going. We're still going strong, guys. So again, I use my usual bird's eye frozen veggies. I don't have to cut anything. It's like $2 or $3. Boom. It's already cut up for you. Throw it in there. Fresh veggies do taste a little bit better, of course, but these are fairly fresh as well. They're just frozen, and I think, you know, getting produce ones are really good, though. Definitely wrong accent. Well, sometimes I mix my Australian accent with my English accent too. So it's, you know, that's what happens sometimes with me. Wonder if I could probably move the music closer to you guys too. Maybe next time, but I want to get music because I know you guys mentioned having music. You know, Sylsa has music when she does her cooking streams, and it's pretty sweet. This was my one way to figure that how to do that. How's everybody's Saturday going? All right, so we're just gonna wait for this to cook, soften up. Then we're gonna throw it in here, let it cool off a little bit. You can hear the jams? Okay, good. As long as, just let me know if they're too loud. Because I can obviously hear them. I think we got this on 60 out of 100, which sounds like it's really loud, but this is a really terrible like machine here. This laptop's really awful. The speakers are here. Our ears are here. The sound's going into here. Being super lazy so far. Go out, did a few errands. Hey, that's all right. Unpaid taxi cab for my daughter. Uh-oh. Somebody's gonna get a talking to. Ash should be doing homework and says she's watching streams and procrastinating until tomorrow. Feels good, man. Yeah, I mean, that's the way I am too. I cannot do something proactively most of the time. I gotta be super motivated for that. So I think we can, while we wait for this to cook, the oven already is preheated to faux hunt it. We're going to need a couple eggs. So as typical with my recipes, I usually do a little bit more than the standard amount. Usually double, but I didn't want to make a double batch of this for some reason. So normally this is one egg, 1.5 pounds of ground beef, which is just a weird amount of ground beef, especially since, you know, I always buy them in pounds. So I usually do like 2 eggs, a little bit extra almond flour, and then, you know, the 2 pounds of ground beef. Today for me, I woke up, was a little bit productive. I was a little productive and then I went to the gym, worked out pretty hard for 1.5 hours, went to go hang out with my grandma and my mom. Came back here, showered, and did a little laundry, watched a little Athena, watched a little Sylsa, and just was kind of lazy myself, but I was super excited to get the stream going. All right, let's just go ahead and get the eggs in here, just to be productive with our lives. But as far as tomorrow, I think I might skip going to my grandma's tomorrow. I usually go on Sundays, but she's making roast, and roast is my least favorite thing that I want to eat. So I might just kind of stick around at home tomorrow. I might go back to the gym again tomorrow, get a lot of work in, because this week's going to be really busy. Hey, Rachel, how you doing? Thanks for hopping in. I appreciate it. Got to see your stream the other day, or yesterday, I think it was. Yeah, so I'll probably get a little bit of a workout in, or another big workout in. Take Monday off. Probably try to do a longer stream tomorrow as well. Now, normally I would do, and I'm going to do my matchup against Regis Kilbin for the tournament championship of best of five, which I'm optimistically hoping I can win this. I really love to beat him because he's the one that really taught me how to get a lot better at Hearthstone. So it'd be pretty awesome to be able to beat him. And I'm like 12-0 in my best of five matchups this like last couple months using these same decks. Yeah, I think it's going to be, yeah, it should be, the tournament should be done tomorrow, which is good because the new expansion is coming out Thursday, so we want to get through all that. All right, sorry, I love this song. So let me catch up on chat, guys. I saw you guys blow me up. I love it. Running away. Take on me. Thank you, Rachel, for the host. I appreciate it. You fell asleep. You came in the stream and fell asleep. I did pre-purchase the packs. I did pre-purchase them. I usually wait till the last minute, but for whatever reason, I didn't wait till the last minute. But that's fine. I figure with all the donations you guys give me, and the stream's growing a little bit, I thought, you know, it'd be a good investment to buy them. I mean, we'll say that. And it's the best. The first expansion here is the best one to buy because it's, you know, it's a larger percentage of the cards, and they're going to be around the longest as well. All right, we're going to toss these out of the way.
We will shape this world to our will.
Thank you, ODK, for the host, girlfriend. All right, this is softened up pretty good. Yeah, I don't know about that garlic. That garlic was pretty funky. It was extra liquidy compared to the brand I normally get. Take on me. It's a little watery-ish, but that's fine. I want to get this out of the pan so it'll start cooling off and burn my hands less when I start digging in there and smashing stuff up. Hey, it's all right. Zero hosts are still hosts here. It's all good. I've been there. You're going to be a big star someday anyway, so I appreciate the host now while you still remember me. Oh, man. All right. It's a little watery-ish still. I think that's the garlic juice. So let's just go ahead. Let's just be done with this. I'm going to beat up the egg a little bit, too, so be at the bottom of this casserole dish. So I've made this dish probably about 20 plus times. I've made this ever since I went paleo about 3 to 4 years ago. It's one of my favorite recipes. It doesn't look pretty, I'll be honest. I'm gonna warn you, it's not gonna look pretty, but it's gonna taste good. All right, so that's done. I'm gonna go cut open the meat. With a knife, preferably. Using 100% ground beef. The Simply Nature, this is Aldi brand grass-fed ground beef. It's the cheapest grass-fed ground beef I can find out there. I think this runs about $5.50 a pound, which is still pretty expensive, especially compared to the traditional corn-fed ground beef that you find here in the Midwest. It's $85.15. So, you know, it's all right. It's a little fatty, but not too bad. Oh, I made this. Oh, all right. But I'm excited for my matchup against Regis tomorrow. Excited to be done with this meta. Although I do have another tournament I have to play too, I guess. I forgot about it. In Jets League. Jets League, I'm 9-0 in 9 weeks. Or, you know, I've won all 9 weeks. I think I've only have seven losses, game losses for all the year. So that's pretty sweet. So I'm pretty proud of that because, you know, thanks to all the learning that I've done from watching other streamers like Kibler and Regis Kilbin and other people over the last years, I've gotten a lot better at Hearthstone, which is pretty sweet. All right. Before I start digging in here, I'm going to catch up on chat. Then I'm going to put this almond flour in here, some the old Frank's Red Hot Sauce, of course. Yep. Secret weapon, some seasonings. Actually, maybe we'll do the seasonings first. Because we got a lot of them. Then we need paprika. Oh no, your wife already planned your day off for the expansion. I know I wanted to take Thursday off and Friday off, but I have an all week leading meetings this week. So actually, this is one of my few weeks where I'm actually busy. I haven't been busy for the last couple weeks, and now I'm finally busy the week. I want to take some time off. Hey, jerks. Nice. Making some roasted Brussels sprouts again. Very nice. I love me some Brussels sprouts. Glad you like the song. So good. I'm glad. Sounds like the ratio is about right then. All right. Seasonings. And if I miss anything, please feel free to respond again, too.
Okay.
Alright, so we need normally 1 egg, 3/4 cup of almond flour. We're going to use 2 pounds, we're using 2 grams of ground beef, so we're just going to up it a little bit. We already got our peppers in there, we got our cloves, we cooked our cloves a little bit. We'll do the hot sauce, we'll do a tablespoon of chili powder, teaspoon of paprika, teaspoon of cumin, chili powder. Okay. Since I got the coconut oil in here, I'm just gonna dump it into the teaspoon instead of digging it out so I don't get coconut oil in here. Could also just use a different, well, I'll use a different spoon. That was the only one we needed, a teaspoon of something. All right, pound of paprika. This is Celissa's Hearthstone playlist again too. Figure she spent a lot of time doing the playlist. It's pretty good. Alright. This is just regular paprika, not smoked paprika like it asks for. Okay. Just evening out the cumin. 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of pepper. Ugh. All right. Yes, I'm actually measuring this week. Probably I could go a little bit extra on the seasonings since we do have a little extra meat compared to the ratios. But it'll be flavorful. But yes, I did see your point. I think it was One Deadly Kid, and you're right. I mean, as long as it tastes good, even if it looks not so great, it's all right. We'll put a little extra pepper in there. It's fine. Oh no, extra good flavor. Whoops. Let's see. So this calls for 3/4 cup of almond flour. Now normally I put 2 eggs in here, so it's actually a little runnier. And then I usually put 1 cup of almond flour. Actually, I use almond meal. This is the cheapest almond flour meal that I've been able to find. I don't know if there is a difference. I'm sure there's a difference between meal and flour, but I think almond flour is just still ground up almonds, and this is just almonds. Maybe there's something else they throw in the flour. All right, so we need a cup. Oh, a cup. All right, so do a cup of that. All right, let me catch up on chat here, guys. You need foods? Guys, Deadly Kitten orders pizza. Roasted pork tenderloin is what Jerks is making. Nice. Always fancy. When are you going to start doing cooking streams, man? I know how much you love a good meal. I feel like that's your next endeavor with streaming, bud. Okay, we got the almond flour. I think that's everything. Stinky cheese, that's an interesting emote. So coconut flour today, I was wondering what that would be like compared to normal flour. Well, I actually used coconut flour when I made my adult chicken nuggets a couple weeks ago. It's very dry, but it's not bad. It's not bad. Oh, for the pizza, yeah. Well, I made pizza rolls yesterday. It was awesome. It felt like I was 20 again. Pizza rolls and steak fries. And my stomach was like, nope, you shouldn't have done that. That was a terrible decision. But hadn't had it forever. Seemed good.
Alright, did I forget anything? Oh, of course. The best ingredient of them all. Hey, Bill Cosby, how you doing? Oh my goodness, is Ben Brode from Russia here again? Guys, the Brodes are here. Are all the Brodes here again? We had follows from EU Ben Brode, NA Ben Brode, Russia Ben Brode. Can't remember all the other ones. I didn't know he was so well-traveled. Why can't I get this open? I lost all my muscles, guys. I used them all today. We're not going to measure this because... Why? Why? Why would you restrict greatness? All right. How am I going to get super messy? Catch my chat before we beat this up. Make it into a loaf shape. Pop it in the oven for a certain amount of time to be determined. 30 minutes. Man, I'm about to entertain you guys for 30 minutes without eating. All right, let's see. Hey, Sleepy, how you doing? All right. I'll catch him in chat here, and then I'm going to miss the chat for a little bit here. Good day, Ben Brode, mate. Oh, Ben Brode from space. I forgot about you. I'm sorry, man. Good day, Ben Brode, Australia, mate. I know Brendan Fraser. I grew up in the 80s and 90s. Brendan Fraser is awesome, man. Good to have you here, Brendan Fraser. Hey, Har Stoner, how you doing? You were on the Cosby Show, Bill Cosby? That's cool. Do you know this other Bill Cosby? Did the voice of Fat Albert. Kind of in some trouble the last couple years. All right, this is pretty... You guys shouldn't be saying this here. This is not a good-looking sight. But raw meat, eggs... Ingredients, you know, rarely ever looks beautiful. But, ugh, man. The worst part of making meatloaf is you gotta shape with your hands. And, you know, depending on how fatty the meat is, it can take a while to wash off your hands, too. Like, sometimes if the fat's kind of cold, it'll stick to your hands. And then you have to wait for hot water in order to, like, melt the fat off of your hands. I know. First world problems. First world problems, guys. It's not getting on my favorite hoodie. Okay, well. Alright, it is a thing here. I'm debating on showing this to you guys. It's pretty gruesome. I think you guys can handle it. But I'm going to wash my hands first, because... Well, they're pretty gross right now. Okay. All right, hands washed. All right, guys, I'm gonna show it to you. Yeah, why wear your favorite hoodie to cook in? I know, I was gonna ask that same question, but it was the first one I found. All my hoodies are my favorite hoodie, though. Hey, David Hasselhoff, you're cooking, I think. Yes, I am cooking. I'm gonna show you, and it's gonna look disgusting, guys. I'm gonna warn you. If you're queasy, look away. What's look cute for you guys? Yeah, I don't know about that. I mean, I do wanna look cute for you guys. I don't know if I do, but this is 2 pounds of grass-fed ground beef, some cooked bird's eye, a couple eggs, some almond flour, some seasoning, and some Frank's Red Hot Sauce. So now we put the biscuit in the basket for 30, 35 minutes. Let's synchronize watches. Oh wait, I don't wear a watch, I'm a millennial. We'll do it on the microwave per usual. I do also wanna make some brown rice too. So I'll do that. But let me catch up and chat. Now we have plenty of time to spend some time together. Harstoner asks, are you gluten intolerant? I am not really gluten intolerant, but I do enjoy gluten-free things for the most part. I don't drink a lot, but when I do drink beer, I definitely notice a little bit more feeling crappy. So I do like to do, you know, like ciders, maybe gluten-free beers. So I'm actually pretty fortunate I don't have a huge intolerance, but I do kind of like eating gluten-free anyways, though. Certainly that stuff is more expensive, though, for sure. But we did a gluten-free tortillas last weekend. We did gluten-free pizza crust a couple weekends ago. I actually had some cauliflower crust that I bought from Trader Joe's. Salsa also recommended that to me. So maybe next weekend we'll make some cauliflower crust pizza because I kind of forgot it was in there. And every time I keep buying pepperoni, I accidentally eat all the pepperoni during the week because it's delicious, obviously. Why? The real question Ben Brode is asking, understandably so, is why is this mate not playing Hearthstone? I will be playing Hearthstone probably in a couple hours. We're gonna cook this. So we got about another 30, 35 minutes before this will be done. We'll scarf it down. Nom, 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 nom. We'll actually start working on a puzzle, a Lego puzzle. I don't know if puzzle is really the right word, but it's a lot of pieces. I'll show it to you guys. So I got this for Christmas, and I've been wanting it. It's been sitting on my kitchen table just being like, hey, you should build me. And I'm like, oh, I don't want to just build a helmet by myself. But so you guys are going to hopefully keep me company here. So we'll start at least. I think it's thought it was going to be like multiple hours, and I don't want to do that much thinking and building. It is a hockey helmet. There you go. Thank you. Probably not for real usage, though. Wouldn't be safe. Probably will not prevent against concussions. I went to Drake University for my undergrad, but then I went to University of Iowa for my MBA. But growing up in Iowa, I'm a huge Hawkeye football fan ever since pretty much high school. I grew up actually watching Iowa Hawkeye basketball, but just really have gotten out of college basketball the last couple of years. All right, let's see. Catch up, make sure I didn't miss anything else. Somebody remembers Brendan Fraser? Can we be friends? Yes, we can be friends. You're already hanging out here. Thank you, Sleepy Time, for coming by. I bet you're right, Hearthstone. I bet Celissa would be jealous that all the Broads are here. All the Benny Boo Boos are here. I'm pretty ecstatic. I'm still fangirling over here myself. I'm really surprised. Ben Broad's got to be a busy dude. He's just hanging out on my little stream here, you know. Makes me feel pretty good. You guys are hanging out here too, which always makes me feel good. I need something more. All right, let me see what else I missed. Prefer beer, but start off with liquor. Yeah, I'll do some liquors too. I mean, there's like supposedly vodkas, you know, quality vodkas like Tito's. It's really actually made with potatoes. So maybe that's a little bit better, I don't know. I'm not a scientist, or a doctor. Although I did play one on TV, but I can't. Supposedly those are all a little bit better, but ultimately it's, you listen to your body and your body will tell you whether it works with your body or not. Yeah, Tito's is solid. Went to school in Philly, learned how to be street smart. Yeah, I bet. I've been to Philly once and spent a ton of time. Well, we spent a couple days there. Didn't do a lot. Of course, saw Liberty Bell. Went to New York City one day with my dad. But this was like 20 years ago. I was like in middle school, high school. So I didn't get to do adult stuff really for the most part. But it was a good trip. We actually drove there from Des Moines, where I'm from right now. So quite a drive. Stopped in Sandusky, stopped in Gettysburg for a night. Went to Philly, stayed there for a couple nights, and like I said, now went to New York City for about 10 hours. We spent probably 6 hours commuting there, and then 10 hours in New York, something like that. It was kind of a crazy trip. All right, let me put this in the fridge. Hey, thank you so much. Good day, Ben Brode. Hopefully you have a good rest of the day. So I'm not in my Australian accent mode here, but I appreciate you stopping by again, Brode. The Holy Brodes. Cheers to the Brode. Oh, LaSalle grad. Nice. Yeah, I'd probably check out Philly again. I don't know. I'm not pretty much the places on my list. I'd like to go back to Seattle. I grew up loving the city, Seattle. I mean, checking out Boston would be cool. Always up for going back to SoCal. I'll plan on probably going to TwitchCon. In San Jose, so that's an excuse to be in California. Maybe I'll just take a whole week off or something and go down to PCH. I think I saw David Hasselhoff. You have some interesting news. Please share your news with the group. Thank you, Ben Bro from Russia. Thank you for stopping by. I appreciate it. Enjoy your vodka. Just filled out my paperwork. I am now in full. Whoa! Congrats to David Hasselhoff! Cheers! Get some hype, guys. Get some, all the hype you got. Give the hype to Mr. Hasselhoff. I haven't checked out your stream, but somebody clipped. I can't remember who it was. It was a really funny clip, though. And Regis Streamer's channel. That was really funny. I was like, oh my god, face reveal, Hulk reveal. It's awesome. So it's good to see you, man. I'm definitely going to try to check you out. I'll be sending vodka to my house. The bro is sending vodka to my house, guys. I won life, obviously. Oh, Fulton, that's who it was, Fulton. That's awesome. Okay. Bills me saying that for the Legos. I got you one deadly kid. And that's good you specified that, because I think if you just say build me with no context, it could be taken lots of ways. All PG, of course, but. Let's see. All right, we should probably not spill the tea on ourselves, but we're also going to start our brown rice in the microwave. You're terrible at pronunciation usernames. Hey, me too. I mean, even people I know, I'll mess up their names, so. Sounded really wrong, sorry. You're fine, DK. You're totally fine. Tote's fine, girl. All right, let me be right back here. All right, well, I'll just talk about alcohol. So this is maybe my only adult beverage I have left in my house. I think I have some down in my man cave, but I've enjoyed this. It is Frank's. Frank's is awesome, by the way. This is a PG stream, mostly. Although now we're going in PG-13, I guess. Although I think you're allowed to drink on stream. It's bad to get drunk on stream, though. But obviously they don't monitor that too hard. But this is the Shell House Pomegranate. It's a really good sparkling spiked seltzer water, whatever. They sell it at Trader Joe's. It's pretty good. I get the pomegranate's good. There's a lemon also. So we'll just have one and see if that adds a degree of difficulty for the puzzle. But while we do that, we're going to make some brown rice. You can do whatever, apparently, as long as it's legal in your state. Except nudity. Good to know. Nudity is off the table, guys. Off the table. All right. Oh, there's our cup that's right in front of me. So I use this instant brown rice. I buy the crap out of it. Though, is that the dog rule? Both men and women have to wear a shirt? Man, dog's going to lose viewers. All right. So we're actually going to do 5 servings, which is an awkward amount. It's usually nice to do even servings. Oop, that's more in the cup. We're going to do 5 servings of rice, 5 servings of meatloaf for the week. I already measured it out on my calorie counter because I'm very particular. I try to stick to a pretty particular diet. You know what? Screw it. We're going to make 6 cups. Very particular, as I just, you know, add some more rice. But that's fine. We can split 6 servings of rice into 5 meatloafs, and it'll be just a little bit extra carbs for the week. See that? I hope you're allowed to drink on stream. I think you are when I last read it. I mean, not that I condone drinking to anybody under the age of 21. But, you know, I'm gonna have a drink. You have to wear a shirt, but sleeves are optional. Sleeves are always optional. No nip, please. That's awesome. That's hilarious. All right. I'm just filling up my rice with water. So with this brown rice, it's I'm doing 6 servings. See, get the instructions on the other bag, other box of it, because I buy like four of these boxes at a time. So six servings, so it's gonna make 3 cups of rice, it's gonna make 6 servings, 2.5 cups of water, which I just put in there, 12 minutes in the microwave. All right, I don't know how that's gonna sound. That sounds really terrible being next to the microwave. We'll move you closer to the music or whatever. Let's see. Presidio would have been banned a long time ago, yeah. I didn't know you've been streaming that long, Deadly Kitten. I just recently saw you in Athena stream. Been awesome having you around here and hanging out with you and chatting with you. Hopefully you're having a better day. The last 2 days have been kind of poopy. Snow bar is still there, guys. It's still cold. I don't think we're going to have a threat of needing a snowblower, but it's still chilly outside. Let's do that. Put that there. Alright. About 15 minutes left, I think. I totally cleared the microwave and I didn't set another clock, but I don't have another clock to set. Snowed there in Michigan last night. Oh man, yeah, it's been chilly. We're supposed to get some snow tomorrow, actually, a couple inches of snow, which is kind of a bummer because a lot of people are traveling in to my city for the meetings that I'm leading all week. Oh, that's good. That's boy trying to see how much I like it. And then, eventually I'm like, yeah, you know, I kind of enjoy it. It's kind of nice having some people to hang out with. And then once I set a schedule, then about a month and a half later, I actually got affiliate, which is pretty exciting. It was right around the time they actually started, like, they just made some, like, settings for it and all that stuff, or some standards, I should say, about how you get it, and then got it, and then just been growing slowly ever since I got affiliate, which I think was about November, December. It's just a goal of mine. Video to do about it, unfortunately. Hopefully it picks back up. Sorry about that, guys. I called my ISP earlier today because we got disconnected a couple times during Hearthstone. I know it was doing that a little bit last time I was doing an IRL stream. It should hopefully come back a little bit. I don't know, doubt the microwave would be affecting that, but probably not. I'm not a scientist though. Alright, so we got... So as soon as this gets out, I need to probably set about 5 more minutes for this. Although I'll know when this is done. Just don't want it to overcook. So I have a tendency, you know, when I'm talking to you guys, I'm hanging out, I'm having a good time, and I forget about responsibilities and all that. Get carried away. Started shaking my computer because, you know, that works. Usually it works, yeah. Yeah, sorry about that, guys. It's on my end. I can see, it does show when I have a poor connection. But it's good to know when it's cutting out, so other people aren't like freaking out. So I appreciate that. I don't know that there's anything I can really do about it. My connection should be able to support, you know, 720p, I would think. But so just continue to go through the exercise of, okay, ISP, can you make this not happen? Well, I don't know. We'll try this. So, yeah. Whatevs. So what else do you guys have planned on for the rest of today, Saturday, and for Sunday? For your weekends? Let's see here. We need this back.
gonna relink the recipe as well. Ooh. How's a hook got a hot date? Or are you just trolling me? What time are you gonna stream tonight then? Is it 9 p.m. your time, Billy Kitten? Ash says, possibly playing more Hearthstone. Had a good run earlier before I had a losing streak. Kinda wanna push the 5, but don't think they'll make it. We want you to make it past 8 today. Well, you just never know. Legit hot day, nice, good luck, man. You have to let us know how it goes. I actually just looked back on match today, but I mean, there's just feels like it's kind of the same people over and over. Details. Well, she's hot, so that's a good start. Hopefully, there's more than just that. But that's all, you know, not a bad way to start it off. I will tell you, I went on a date about, I think it was a week ago. Very attractive online. Different in person. She's still pretty though. I kind of, my gut kind of told me even before, got on the, or met with her, that I was like, I don't know if this is going to work, but we have some common interests, and we met up, and I'm like, she's kind of mean, so I'm like, I don't know, I think we'll just call this one good. That's good, you gotta have some common interests for sure. Good, well, cheers, hope it goes well for yourself, sir. So yeah, I got a match and I'm like, nobody there. I'm fine with that. I'm pretty much enjoying the single life. Yeah, she's gonna, I don't know, not necessarily mean. She's kind of mean. Yeah, I don't know. I don't want to give too many details, but she's very direct sometimes and come off pretty mean. Not necessarily to me, but to other people. I have not heard of Badoo.com. Nice, that's where you met your boyfriend from. I know, maybe I'll take a look at it, but I'm kind of fine with once my match goes up, just kind of being done with dating for a bit. I did meet somebody a couple months ago that I really liked, but it was just bad timing because her mom was in really bad health, and so she didn't really want to date anybody like that. So you say the paid day sites aren't, or you don't like them. Free ones are just as good. I don't know. I kind of disagree, actually. I've been on Plenty of Fish before. It is ghetto. At least when I was on there a couple years ago. But, I mean, hopefully it's better now. And that could just be me, my little judgment. But there is not very good selection on there. Not saying anything about the girls. I mean, just not a good overall general selection. Meaning that, you know, a lot of people are very flaky. And just didn't seem like there was a ton of people on there is what I mean by that. I've done, what's the other really popular one that supposedly uses science and algorithm? OkCupid, that's the one. OkCupid was a decent one as far as a free site. That wasn't too bad. But my theory with this, and this is why I kind of like Match, is Match has a lot of people on there of all the pay sites, so that's good. But I feel like if you really want to find, you know, maybe a relationship, which is more what I would be looking for, it's actually nice that other people are paying for it too, because you know they're committed, because they're paying money for it, they care enough about it, they're gonna do that. I've gotten so much flakiness, you know, on Bumble, Tinder, and OkCupid. OkCupid has been a decent free site though, but I think for the most part, I think I would, if I keep doing the online dating, I would probably stick with free sites. But you know, to that point, I've done Bumble, and that's not too bad. It's a lot easier to get into. There's more selection, of course, but there's also a lot more people that are not really, you know, that attentive to it, or they're just kind of like, half a foot in the door for dating and all that.
instead of Twitch as if you just want to get laid? Did you mean Tinder instead of Twitch? Was that a Freudian slip? Any opportunities to worker friend of friends? Not really. Most of my people I work with are a lot older. I've always kind of been in, I don't know if I've like, I've been pretty advanced in my career, so I've always seemed to work in jobs where I've worked with a lot of people that are 10 plus years older than me. So they're all married and they don't have friends anymore and all that stuff. Or all their friends are super old, which is fine. But I'm, like I said, I'm actually pretty much about the happiest I've ever been. And I'm pretty okay with not, you know, spending that much energy on dating. I was actually on a podcast about a month or two ago, and I talked about dating. That would be terrible. I figured he meant Tinder. That would be the first time I've heard about Twitch being a way to hook up, but whatever. I will go down. I was going to make some bad jokes, but we'll keep it PG. What was I going to say? Oh, I was on a dating podcast there. So I was on a podcast. I talked about dating and just how, you know, I spent a lot of years of my life, like from 23 to 33, and I'm 34 now, trying to find somebody, you know, and dating is just one of those things that, like, when you try too hard about it, then it's like, actually, you're not your best self sometimes. So it's, you know, that is kind of one of those things where it's like, okay, let it come to you, see what happens. So that's kind of the approach I'm taking, but, you know, I found so much more happiness, with myself and, you know, finding enjoyment and love, self-love and all that good stuff has really been a better course of action for me. I mean, I did find somebody that I did really, really like a year and a half ago, and that was the first time I just knew I was in love before I even met her in person, and it just didn't end up working out, unfortunately. But that was a good experience because I learned a lot from it, and it actually kind of gave me hope. I'm like, oh, okay, so now I know when I date somebody, I know when I like them. You know, I know when I'm in love. I know when things are easy. So now I know if I'm talking to somebody and my gut's like, I don't know about this, I know I could probably just save my energy and save everybody's time and such in that scenario. Because I've definitely been, I talked about this in the podcast. I've probably been on more than 100 first dates in the last 10 years. It's probably been, and that's with a couple years of being in relationships in between those 10 years too. Nice, this is a second date. That's very good. Second dates are good. You get all that awkwardness out of the way on the first date. You have a little bit more excitement, stuff like that. It's good. It's good. So I'm attempting to divvy up the rice kind of in fifths. It's not really a great way to do fifths. You can kind of go in the middle and then like kind of like a little slip in the middle. That's kind of how I do fifths. I think we got about 3.5 more minutes of the meatloaf. So we got our brown rice there. Guess we can start partitioning it out. This is my life. I eat out of plastic things for my whole life. Don't go on dates much? Well, that's all right. You're gonna be a Twitch superstar, so the guys will be coming to you, DK. No effort needed. Made a mess. Still good. That looks about even. Trying to get those as even as possible. So we have 2 more servings in here. So you will totally be a star, Deadly Kid, and I can see it. I can see it, girl. If you want to be. Not everybody wants to be a star, though. And that's fine. Okay. We'll plate the rest of this rice here.
Come on.
What kind of puzzle are you gonna do? Or you said you're gonna do Legos? Is it like you're building like a Lego puzzle or anything specifically, DK? Yeah, dating is very challenging. I mean, that's why I chose to do dating on the podcast, is like that's been one of the most frustrating things for me the last 10 years, but I've learned so much, especially in the last, every year I learn a little bit more about myself and about dating. But I think it just depends on how you look at it. I used to think it sucks, and it is, you know, can be challenging and draining, but since I've learned so much more about myself and maybe learned a different approach to take with dating, it's been a lot better, especially now that I'm not tryharding at it and, you know, trying to be like, okay, well, you know, we need this date to go really well. I need to do this, I need to do this. I don't do that stuff anymore. Okay, Ashley, never dated, talked to a lot of guys, but never really committed. My first boyfriend was cool, but was an unhealthy relationship. Yeah, he's got lucky in the current one. That's awesome. Congrats, Ash. That's awesome. And you're pretty young too. And I don't mean this in a demeaning way. So hopefully it continues to go well. But you know, always make sure you're happy. I mean, that's number one. You know, that's one of the best advices I can give that I've learned, is I think we're always better off not being in a relationship than we are being in a bad relationship. That's one thing I feel very passionate about. And I see people in bad relationships, and you're like, you know, you're gonna be okay by yourself. Just in case. I'm just saying that as a general statement though. But so that's one thing that I've learned that I wish, you know, more people knew, is, you know, if you're not really into it and you're not happy with your life, a relationship's not gonna bring you happiness. It may make you believe you're happy at first, or it may bring you a little bit of happiness, but in the long run, you're not going to be happy. Because you ultimately have to have your self-love. I mean, it goes back to that saying that you have to love yourself before you love somebody else. That was a loud sound. All right, so we should be good to go. Let's take a gander at our meatloaf. We worked hard on it. Yeah, streaming has brought me so much happiness. I agree. And that's like, I was getting ready to move to the Twin Cities because I'm like, you know, I just need to change the scenery. But once, you know, I've continued to grow and meet so many more new people, it has brought a ton of happiness to me. And so now I'm like, well, I'll just stay where I'm at because it's cheaper where I live. I got my house. Don't need to do that. Unless I get a Blizzard job. That's the only reason why I want to move, is move to SoCal for the Blizzard job. But that might be a little ways down the road, if ever. Let's see. I think it's done-ish. It should be fully cooked. I think I want to put it in the broiler to sear the top of it. Because I've never done that before, and I think that'll be good. Okay, let's broil the crap out of this. All right, going in. Thank you. I believe those are wise words. Thank you very much, DK. All right, well, about a minute. Broil it. Get lobster claws. You have to love yourself on stream before you love somebody else. Yeah. Yeah. You do have to love your inner self. Love who you are. So expensive there. What do you mean? Was that meant for me? Yeah, I mean, ultimately, I think it just comes down to, if you're not happy in a relationship, figure out why. Is the person a bad person? Oh, yeah, Cali is super expensive. Yeah, you ultimately got to figure out why you're not happy. Is it the other person, or is you're not happy with yourself and all that stuff? And I really wish more people would do that, because I hate to see people get, you know, engaged or get married, and they're not happy with that stuff, and they think that's going to bring them happiness. So I've seen that quite a bit. But, yeah, Cali is super expensive. I was doing the research, and it's 150%.
Don't interrupt me, microwave. 150% more expensive than where I live currently. Where I live currently is a pretty inexpensive place to live. And of course, Southern California is a very expensive place to live. Yeah, prices of property are ridiculous. So I have a mortgage. It's like about $700 a month. And I own a house, and it's now a four-bedroom house. It was three-bedroom when I bought it. I think renting a one-bedroom apartment in Irvine would be about $1,600. Yeah. You know, about 150% more. Probably more than that now. That's actually when I looked, I think, 2 years ago. All right, that's looking better. I like the broil was a good call. Good call, guys. Good job, team. All right, we're gonna take it out. We're gonna cut her open. I'll show it to you. All right, so again, I'm gonna warn you, it doesn't look beautiful. The reason why I don't think it looks beautiful is because there's little kind of white patches, and I think it's the fat rising to the top, and I think a little bit of the egg, so like the egg yolk too. But some of it, trust me, it does really taste really good here. Hey, Zach Jamie with the huge host, buddy. How you been, man? Thank you for the host. All right, we just finished our meatloaf, Zach. Come grab a slice. So this is Southwest Meatloaf. I don't want to flip it all the way over because it does have some greasy juices in there. Everything is beautiful. Thank you so much, dear. We were talking about food. It was meant to be, Zach. It's meant to be, buddy. Thank you so much for the host, man. How you been? I saw you were playing some D3. You're going to make some Southwest Meatloaf soon. Good. I think I posted the recipe in my Discord, too, so you should have it. Unless you already have your own version. Hate. No hate, but I've never meatloaf look like that. Never had meatloaf look like that. Hey, Bombino, thank you for the follow. I just saw your name yesterday. I'm trying to remember where. I feel like it was in Funky Monk's chat? Or maybe it was in Rachel's. I bet it was in Rachel's. That's where it was. It was in Rachel's chat. That's awesome. Thank you, guys. We're just cutting the old meatloaf open into fifths for the week. Gonna be hot. Yeah, it turned out okay. I think I can definitely see the extra juice action going from the, I think the garlic and not cooking out all the juice from the peppers. Oh yeah, let me send the recipe again here. You don't know how you haven't followed me? Well, you follow me now, and I appreciate you having you here, Bombino. It's awesome of you. Thank you so much. It's all good. We're going to eat. So to cut this in fifths, I'm going to use the same methodology of like basically cutting like this for fourths and then like trimming off a little bit of the sides to make a fifth. It's not scientific. It's just guessing. It's fine. Guys, it's fine. Don't worry about it. It's fine. So the meatloaf is kind of broken up because I'm taking the piece that's kind of beat up in the middle. Let's see. So let's just go ahead and divvy this up now. Oh, yeah. Qué bueno. Now, I love meatloaf. I grew up on it. And, you know, with the paleo life, it's pretty good recipe. And this is one of the first recipes I found was this. And for those of you that are subscribed to me, I have a recipes channel. So you can find some of the recipes that I've made before on stream. Some of my meatloaf recipes on there. Of course, I'll try to always link whatever I'm cooking at the time, and then on the YouTube video, I'll try to put the recipes, if there is one, associated with that. Okay, let's do this. All right, we got all this beautiful juice that we want to get in there too. Close enough for the belly?
Looks like lasagna. Yeah, it does look like the same in the belly. It's definitely not lasagna, but lasagna does sound pretty good. I actually had some, before I went paleo, I had some really awesome lasagna recipes. Some of them in the crock pot too, which is even better because you can do a lot less work. So there was like a buffalo chicken lasagna. Oh, so good. And then Mexican lasagna, which was tortillas, cheese. I mean, really, it was like a... It was basically all the ingredients you would use in a burrito or a taco, but it was in a crock pot and layered like a lasagna. Pretty baller. All right, we want to take advantage of this delicious freedom juice. Try to split this up. Just some fat with some seasoning there. Want to take advantage of all that delicious flavor. Start the sink. We'll let that soak in the sink for about 12 days probably. Seems like a good amount of time, right? Delay our problems here. All right, I'm gonna cover these up before they get dry out and get too cool. Too cool for school, that is. And then we're gonna be just in time for eating and building Legos. Hey, Movie, how's it going, buddy? Oh, you had to go to the hospital? Dude, I hope you're okay. I think you might have mentioned something. I feel like you came in and you're like, you weren't feeling well or something. How are you doing, man? Hopefully you're doing alright. Alright. About right. Oh, here, I'll show you. We were going to see it on the table here, but it's just basically a mound of beat up meatloaf and some brown rice. Oh, Aiden is allergic to Imodium. Okay, so is the kiddo. Or is that your, well, wait, no. I'm trying to remember your, well, who is Aiden? I can't remember. Aiden is your son, right? Or daughter, sorry? Sorry, I'm really bad with kids. Son, okay, sorry. Bad at kids, guys. Sorry. Taryn, oh, I didn't know you had... Okay, that's where I was confused, because I knew you had a daughter, but I'm like, I didn't know you had a son, too. I thought that was your first kiddo you had with Taryn. Okay. That was where my part of my confusion was. Okay, let's... Slissamon, how you been doing? How you been doing, Slissamon? We just finished our meatloaf. You just missed it. So Slissa, you've never had meatloaf before, and you can kind of see it. I don't know if you want to see this though. This is not the prettiest meatloaf ever. Far from it. And now it's all beat up too. And I'm gonna eat it on the table in front of all my friends. Be a total jerk. But I'm gonna show it to you guys one more time here. Again, it's just kind of a mound of a bunch of meat. It's got some peppers in it, some seasoning. On top of some brown rice. We're gonna eat it and it's gonna be good. All right, I'm gonna move some things to the table, including you guys. You guys are moving to the table. Okay. All right, I'm gonna move you guys. Brace yourselves, put on your seatbelts. This is your playlist, Lissa. I was gonna just say, you should recognize this. Buckle up, guys, I told you. I warned you. Oh, guys, I told you to buckle up. Seriously, you guys, go home. Go home, Twitch chat. You've been drinking. Okay, let's see how this looks. I'm gonna try to read chat from the laptop. It's a little easier. Oh. Yes, this playlist is complimented. Celissa, thank you so much. We used it last night too. I didn't see what band it's just. It's a good song. You know all the celebrities, Alyssa. You were born to be a celebrity because you've been around so many celebrities. You know, like Nick Foles, Gronk, this band. So it's pretty good. She's a celebrity, guys. She's gonna sign autographs later. Okay. How was the rest of your stream, Alyssa? I can only catch one of the decks. The deck that went, the tech deck, and a little bit of the one before that. She is a Kardashian. I don't know. Some people might not take that the right way. I'm gonna turn this down a little bit. Just a name dropper. Hey, I am too. Man, I've been name dropping it all stream, so it's fun. What do you got going on tonight? Gonna hang out, play some more Hearthstone. Gonna go out in the real world. It's scary. The real world's scary, guys. get her names if you can drop them. I agree, Zach. Three good decks, two bad decks. It's good. So you probably hit a positive record then with three good decks. Oh, that's right. The Bree and her Bree's mom thought she was Kardashian. That's right. I could maybe see that. No, I don't know. I think, not that I've watched Kardashians a lot, but Alyssa seems way more sophisticated than the Kardashians. Oh, yeah, I name drop you all the time. I'm a fangirl, what can I say? I mean, you followed me on the Twitter, you followed me on Twitch, it's pretty good. Currently out in the real world. What? Guys, she's out in the real world, and she's talking to us. She might need help. Guys, she is hostage. We need to save Alyssa now. Call the authorities. Somebody communicate with Pyra. Pyra will be there, save the day. Fangirl, totally fangirl. Let's see, my fangirl moments so far have been with Alyssa following me. I fangirled pretty hard. Killboy liked one of my tweets. Granted, I mentioned him in the tweet. Killboy's wife followed me on Twitch, and she said she was gonna watch one of my first cooking video, which I don't think she did, but that's fine. Those are probably my top three fangirl moments. It's fine. I bet Pyra's enjoying it. Bought doorknobs. Nice. Way to be responsible. I need to buy some more light bulbs. Because I realized yesterday that three of them are out, and I only had one left to replace that. So, fun little Easter egg when you watch my IRL streams. Not all the light bulbs are in. I'm gonna do what I never heard what you're gonna cook tomorrow, Alyssa. I do enjoy your brunch streams. It's pretty good. I have a big best of five tomorrow I'm very excited about. I'm playing against Regis Kilbin. Playing in his subscriber-only tournament. And I've been undefeated all season between that tournament, which I've only played three matchups. I went 3-0, 3-0, 3-2. Now I'm in the championships of his subscriber tournament. And then I've been playing in Jet_2014's season-long tournament. And I'm 9-0 there. And I've only got seven game losses with these decks. So I'm really excited, really hoping I can kind of finish the season undefeated. Then I have at least in Regis's, win the championship. Because I've learned a lot about Hearthstone from Regis over the last year and a half, 2 years. And then in Jets League, I've been just dominating. So hopefully I win that, because then I'll win like $50 or 50 packs or something like that. Ooh. Waffles, breakfast burger. I did take your suggestion on the cauliflower crust. I bought some of that. I have two of those in the freezer. So I thought about maybe trying those next weekend. Should probably be healthy because of Mexico. Yeah, I want to stay away from some carbs then, I guess. Too many carbs. Otherwise, you're gonna have to keep. You're gonna do 2 days on the lifting. I have a waffle maker though. I've actually made some protein waffles, which aren't too bad. What's a good thing? I mean, bacon. I guess bacon's not super, super healthy, but it's not bad actually.
My name is Giovanni Giorgio, but
I don't know, one meal's not gonna hurt you. Make something delicious. Do it for the fans, do it for the shorties. This is the puzzle I'm gonna make, guys. Not all of it today. For those of you that just popped in, if you want to know the tea of choice, Yogi brand tea, not sponsored yet. Hey Nebula, how you doing, buddy? Not sponsored yet. May never happen. We'll see. Join their ginger tea, which is currently out of reach, but we're gonna alleviate that problem. Everybody did, well, not everybody loves bacon. Not everybody. We have a copious amounts of liquids, guys. It just kind of happened, so don't be surprised if I have to go to the restroom about 12 more times. Let's see. Okay, that's weird. Get away. Okay, so we have delicious sparkling water, per always. You're getting roped right now on ladder? Beat him? Yeah, just show him up. Just beat him. Just beat him. Don't let him trigger you. We got our good old pomegranate sparkling water, because you guys are talking about alcohol. Then we have some ginger tea. Cheers, Gavinus. Man, I ate a big lunch. I accidentally ate like 9 Oreos with my lunch. Not paleo. Fun fact. So I think the meatloaf turned out pretty good. I mean, like I said, I made it 20 times, so it's hard to mess it up. It's kind of I'm on autopilot with it for the most part. Again, like I said, it doesn't look beautiful, but it tastes great. I'm trying to think of a good way to describe it. It's almost like taco meat, but not quite as spicy as taco meat. But imagine like a taco-y meatloaf with peppers. Yeah, that's probably a good way to say it. How can you not dance this song? Dancing while I eat, it's pretty good. I don't know, Holt. I think you should just not rope him. I think you should move really fast. When people try to BM, I try not to react the way they want me to. I try not to react the way they expect me to. But to that point, I mean, if you take the extra time to think through your turn, you know, you might have a better chance of beating them too, which will always feel really sweet. Movies drinking iced black tea. I've never heard of it. Well, I've heard of black tea, but I've never heard about drinking it iced. Playing WoW, crafting up to 110. Are you still playing on the EU server? Like with Rachel and Waving and everybody? Yeah, I might actually. So, as you mentioned, that Hasselholt. I may actually not do my stream in the evening. I may end my stream before WrestleMania because my buddies do want me to come over. It'd be pretty fun.
One Deadly Kitten had iced white chocolate mocha. Was that, you make that at home or did you go to like Starbucks? That sounds fancy. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I have not really been a coffee drinker too much. There was a point in my life when I first started my office job 14 years ago, when I was still in college, that they had like some vending machine coffee, which is just loaded with sugar and cream. I'm like, oh, this is so good, and just chug it. I'm like super jittery. I'm like, yeah, this doesn't seem like the how a human should be. So I quit that habit, and then I never really needed that much caffeine. Usually one bag of tea is usually good enough for me now. But again, you guys know that I like to go to bed early and make sure I get a good night's sleep too. So that's, it's pretty important to me. I know a lot of you guys have like other responsibilities or do other things. So I've made sure that I plan my life around making sure I have a good night of sleep, get a workout in, and hopefully getting some streaming in as well on a consistent schedule. Kitty looks like a Starbucks kind of girl. Yeah, I can see that. I can see that a little bit. But she seems very down to earth though too. That was a joke. Hey, who cares? How you doing, buddy? I did make food. I'm still eating it right now, actually. You might not be able to see it because of all my plethora of beverages. But I'm kind of beat up the meatloaf because it's not a super thick meatloaf. It probably could be if I did the right ratio of almond flour and eggs, but I'm not. The typical soccer mom look. You said that, not me. I'm not touching that comment, movie. How's your day going? Who cares? Oh, yeah, I got a weird pepper in here. Excuse me. Yeah, there's, sometimes you get peppers that are like, you get, they're very hard, which is why sometimes I'm kind of getting sick of using the bird's eye, but it's so much easier. But once it's summer, then I'll use maybe more real peppers and cut them up. You're going to have to ask Movie on that one. Yeah, he says soccer moms are awesome. I'm not going to say anything either way. I don't want to get involved in that, judging a soccer mom. All moms are great. That is a Hawkeye football helmet. But it's like, it's 1,347 pieces. A lot of pieces. I think we'll get started on it shortly, if I can ever finish this food. ODK always with the cutest emotes. And the cutest emote award goes to One Deadly Kitten. I'll get you a trophy. So, Hasselhoff's got a date tonight, second date. ODK is streaming tonight. Ash is procrastinating on homework, smart. Play some Hearthstone. The cutie emote cup. I like that. Should be a contest. What else did I miss? Who else had stuff going on that I missed? Bum, 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 bum. Is the music still good? The ratio to my voice to the music? Who cares? You got a project due at midnight. Always with the like the rough weekends of homework and projects, man. Feels stressful, man. Mm-hmm. Music's good. Thank you, Ash. I appreciate it, dear. Yeah, we'll get a start on the puzzle. We'll see how it goes. Like I said, I think it's supposedly... I think it said estimated 3 hours. But this is ages 12 and up. I don't know if I have the attention span to get that far. Be pretty ironic if I have a worse attention span than a 12-year-old. But we'll find out. We'll find out. Mm-hmm. I know they're not your emotes, but they're still... You're like you're collecting... You're hoarding good emotes. You're hoarding the cutest emotes and you like use them perfectly. It's awesome. So, you guys read these instructions so you can tell me what to do. Thank you, Zach, for the positivity. You can do it.
You can do it!
We'll see. I just thought I'd try something a little different than Hearthstone, but we'll do Hearthstone a little bit. Who cares? Do you have the cutest emote? You have a great emote. I wouldn't say it's cute. It's just a great emote. Actually, it could be a lot better. I thought about having my buddy who does comic book stuff, trying to get him into the Twitch world, because he's incredibly talented with comic books. He actually came out with his own comic. So I want him to like maybe build me something new. But this is something I got from a friend, and you know, people don't seem to hate it, so that's all right. I know, I'm really happy to have you here, DK, to help me with the Legos. Two Lego experts, baller! Yeah! That's good, because I haven't done Legos for probably about 25 years. I played the Lego game once. You do my programming, I'll do the Legos. Nope. What kind of programming are you doing? I have written a little bit of code in my day. Not very much. Very basic visual VBA code. It's like Microsoft's like programming language, I guess you'd call it. Or script query language. I've done a little bit of that. Can you trade homework with Legos? I'm not trading, guys. I'm sorry. I'm not trading. I love the effort. I love the thought. I'm done with school for this very reason. For homework, projects, all that stuff. Nope. I did. Let's see. 4 years of college. 12 years of the normal school. Plus kindergarten. 17 years, and then I did my MBA. I did that over 5 years, but that was like one class at a time. So, I lost count. So I think it was 22 years of school in my 34 years of life. I'm done with it. Glad you guys are doing it. Make thousands of friends. Very highly educated. Me fail English? That's impossible. Almost done with food. So Who Cares says, well, over the course, I've been building different components of a computer, like chips and software programming and everything in between, putting it all together. Yeah, I didn't know what to call it, DK. Like the elementary, middle school, high school, normal school that most people go through. All right. For some reason, my food is just so much harder to get through when I'm talking with you guys. The whole eating like 85% slower. Probably much more than that. Guess that means I should probably eat with real life human beings more often. Yeah, I bet that would be useful to you, Who Cares, to have that fundamental understanding. Like, if you have problems with the game or just with your computer, you're like, oh, well, That's because of this blah 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 thing. Speaking of knowledge, no. You eat way slower than me, really? Really, Ash? This is really slow for me. Like, I mean, that was a decent sized meal though, but like, you know, if I'm not on camera, I'm just like just shoveling in, just very efficient. Done.
All right, let's put this in the trash.